some health news now. The FDA giving final approval for a new breast cancer drug more than 2 months earlier than expected. The drug is called Ibrance, and it works by targeting certain proteins involved in the growth of cancer cells. Apparently, this could forever change the way the disease is treated. For more on this, we are joined by Dr. Erica Hamilton, Associate Director of the Breast Cancer Program at the Sarah Cannon Research Institute. Dr. Hamilton, is this a game changer?
Thanks for having me, Jenna. I think this definitely has the possibility of being a game changer. This study that was the study that palbociclib or Ibrance was approved off of was Paloma-1, and it showed a near doubling of the progression-free survival for women with first-line metastatic hormone receptor-positive breast cancer from 10.2 to 20.2 months. There is a confirmatory study underway, Paloma-2, to confirm this, but I think that this definitely has the potential to be practice-changing in clinic the way first-line patients are treated.
Interesting. In simplest of terms, how is this different than what's already on the market?
Yeah, so this drug, palbociclib, is given in combination with letrozole, one of the very common endocrine therapies that we treat breast cancer with. So in this trial, women either receive letrozole alone, which is the standard of care, or letrozole in combination with the palbociclib. Palbociclib is a CDK4/6 inhibitor, and the CDK4/6 pathway is important to tell cancer cells to divide. So by giving a medication like palbociclib, we can block the signal that tells the cancer cell to continue to grow and divide.
Interesting. So what are the side effects? As we hear from, you know, all sorts of medications out there for cancer, there's a lot of side effects. What about this one?
Right. And that's, you know, a great piece of news for patients is that this medication is oral. It's a pill that patients can take at home, and it's very well tolerated. We've had the opportunity to work with this compound in clinical trials at Sarah Cannon, and it's very well tolerated for patients. The most common side effects is a low white blood cell count, which is normally asymptomatic for patients, as well as some fatigue or just general tiredness.
Interesting. So not major side effects, although those certainly
right.
can impact your life. And I don't want to make light of it. Breast cancer has impacted my family, and I know so many others, doctor. And it's interesting to see that the FDA approved this quicker than thought. Is there any risk attached to that it somehow has been approved so much faster than what was expected?
Yeah, I mean, I think we've had enough information to feel comfortable that this drug is safe. The study that it was approved on, Paloma-1, was a smaller-based trial. The confirmatory study that I mentioned earlier is a larger study with hundreds of patients. You know, the approval is contingent on the fact that Paloma-2 confirms the results of Paloma-1. But I think that it's probably going to look very similar, and I think that this has the opportunity to be the new standard of care.
So can patients walk in today and say to their doctor, listen, I just heard about this new drug on Fox News and I really would like to try it. Is it accessible to everybody?
Yes, they can. And I think that that's one of the encouraging things about the approval of this, not only for metastatic breast cancer patients, but also cancer patients in general and the medical community is that I think this represents another big step by the FDA to get these promising breakthrough drugs out to the clinic sooner and to patients.
Real quickly, this is always the million-dollar question. Is this a sign that we're closer to a cure for cancer? Are we getting closer, doctor?
Yeah, I think cancer has become more of a chronic illness. You know, before, patients didn't do very well with cancer. You know, every year we make more and more breakthroughs. We have more drugs available, better ways to treat cancer. And so I think this really is becoming a chronic disease that patients live with and can continue to live their lives with instead of, you know, a devastating diagnosis sometimes.
It's nice to have a little good news or something to focus on here. Dr. Hamilton, thank you so much for the time today. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
That is good news.
All right, new developments in the battle against